Hello, this is the Tradesight U.S. Stocks and Futures Market Preview and Domestic Economic Data Roadmap for the week beginning Monday, 22nd of September 2014 and ending Friday the 26th. Just a note, this week ahead, we've just finished triple expiration. That's out of the way. We just finished a two-day Fed meeting. We don't have any significant economic data. We'll look over that here briefly. None of the numbers that usually would stand out as having huge market implications. So what are we here to focus on this week? Well, first, it's the start of a new options cycle. We have started to see much better movement in the market. The Alibaba IPO is behind us. And so this is a wide open week, I will say, because the following week, you've got Monday and Tuesday. Tuesday is September 30th. It's the last day of the quarter. And that's usually a very flat trading day as they just let everything print out where they want it for the end of quarter statements. It's pretty significant. Heading into the last, I can't believe I'm saying this, the last 3 months of 2014 already. So Monday and Tuesday next week might be a little iffy, but this coming week first, other than Mondays might be a little slow because it's the first true day of the new options cycle. We could have a straight up decent trading week, I think. There's a lot going on in the world. You've got the Alibaba thing to push money around. And so it'll be interesting. It'll be interesting to see. We just came off of an amazing trading week here at Tradesight. Last few weeks since coming back from Labor Day have been great, but this last week in particular was really, really solid, and our win ratio was way up there. And so I have good feelings for what's coming all the way forward, all the way until April, of course. This is a great time of year from a trading perspective. So let's get to some of the analysis here. Here's the ES. This is the S&P E-mini futures contract. This is the Z contract. We'll go to the front month real quick here just so you can see the action. And we did sweep new highs and failed, again, coming into options expiration. So Tuesday, it looks like we got that options unraveling move. That pushed us up Wednesday, Thursday, up a little higher. And everybody geared up for the debt on Friday, the Alibaba IPO on Friday. By the way, I'll point out the net for the day, the S&P lost one and the NDX lost two. That's pretty much what you expect for triple expiration. But we did go up first and then fill the gap, go a little lower. So actually, there was some range, even though there shouldn't usually be for expiration. And a lot of the focus was, of course, on Alibaba. We'll talk about that in a moment. All right, so let's look at that's the S&P Cash Index. Nothing explosive there. Here's the NDX. New high, closing new high on Thursday, and then just down a little bit here on Friday. Amazing how flat it's been for the month, though, if you really look at it. And actually, what's amazing is how much better we've done in September since the volumes come back. But once again, look where we're closing. It's at, on the futures contract, is at this 2,000 level, right near the 2,000 level. And that has been the magic number since the last week of August. We're going on a full month now. Only 2 days where we have closed more than 4 points away, 5 points away from the 2,000 level in the ES. That's pretty remarkable. But yet trading action certainly much improved from what we saw in August in terms of intraday action. Here's the semiconductor index. Remember, volume's big on Friday. It was big on Friday, but that's really expiration related. But when you look at this, this is an outside day down. That's an engulfing bar to the downside. So that doesn't bode well for Monday. Biotech's held up a little bit better. It was the only real green sector on my list. Here's a look at Google. Google's going to be a breakout. That's a cup and handle. That's going to be on our list for triggers on Monday in the stock report. Here's a look at Apple. Didn't do too much this week. Let's glance at oil really quick. Rolled over again, heading back towards the lows after one pop. And then gold. Gold just doesn't look pretty at all, does it, making new lows? If you're bullish on gold, you're definitely losing right now. A lot of alerts going off here as I'm flipping through these charts because we have several stocks that are nine bars down, set up for a new startup phase. Here's one of them in Amazon, completed nine bars down on Thursday. Take a look at Tesla. Oops, Tesla. Not really a positive week here on Tesla, sitting on the static trend line of the last move down. So that's what we have in terms of trading action. Here's a look at the NASDAQ volume. Look at the 10-day moving average heading back towards 1.8. That is helped by the fact that, remember, you always get a volume boost on Friday of expiration. In August, you can see the one day that was up above 1.6 in the last half of the month. That was expiration in August. That's a single expiration in the slowest month of the year. Other months, you'll notice the Friday expiration, the volume's higher. This is a triple expiration. So just like June had a pretty big volume day for expiration, and so did March, this is another one of those triple expirations. So that's the 2.6, aided, of course, by Alibaba going public as well. and we'll look at that momentarily. All right, here's a look at, oh, let's just go straight to the Alibaba, get it out of the way, just so everybody's aware. They opened, the stock was priced at 68, they opened it at $92.70. Pretty wide opening bar, as you would expect, a lot of orders out there. They tried to push it higher. They swept the highs of the first five-minute bar. If your strategy was to buy over the high of the opening five-minute bar, you better have had a quick stop in there, because it certainly came back very quickly and then dropped all the way back. The low of the opening bar was 90. It spent some time at 92.70. That's where the opening price was. It then went down, spent some time near 90. It did sweep under 90 to stop out those people who had a stop under the low. Got a little bounce, faded back. They end up closing it within 50 cents of where it opened after all that. So from a IPO success point, you could call this a success for sure. They brought the stock public and held it at a good premium to the public offering price. So that's a positive on the opening of trading. That's what didn't happen with Facebook, obviously. So this is a little more positive. On the flip side, from an intraday trading perspective, you look at the volume and where it all occurred, probably a lot of people that didn't do so well trading this stock on Friday. All right, let's look at the week in on the ES contract. We're going to go to 10-minute bars so we can see the whole week. And what you'll notice is positive week, generally speaking. Opened flat on Monday, pretty flat day. Still had a great trading day for us. Gap down a little on Tuesday, filled that and proceeded higher. That looks like an options unraveling move, but it started after 90 minutes instead of after an hour. So it's hard to say exactly what went on there, but it may have been some unraveling, even though the Fed meeting was ongoing. It's a little unusual, but it happened. But we did fill the gap Tuesday. Wednesday, small gap up, which we filled, and then turned up after the Fed announcement before coming back to close, barely positive. Thursday gapped up. We have not filled that gap. Friday gapped up, and we did fill that gap. Matter of fact, we closed even. And again, triple expiration, you do sort of expect to close about even. You don't usually go far on triple expiration, just like you don't typically go far for end of quarter, which is a week from Tuesday. All right, here's the NASDAQ side, not much different. Okay, gained 35 points for the week. All right, quick look at economic data coming out this week. Monday, existing home sales, no big deal. Tuesday, housing price index, no big deal. Wednesday, mortgage index, new home sales, crude oil inventories, no big deal. Thursday, initial and continuing jobless claims, durable orders, no big deal. Natty gas. Friday, the third look at GDP, which is no big deal, and Michigan sentiment. We have no Fed meeting, none of our big announcements, no options expiration. Monday probably be a little light because we're starting a new options cycle. But, you know, it's a good time of year for trading. We don't need all this news. Matter of fact, it keeps us from having to worry about stuff. We can just trade straight through. Looking forward to this week. We will help you out in the trading lab. As usual, hope to see you there. Have a great trading week.